small packages like pearls and shells from the sea. My name is Tom Thumb, and you'll never see a boy that small as me. I'm Tom Thumb, see there I am asleep in my bed. I'm so small I can use an empty seashell for a bed. You know, good things do come in small packages like bubblegum, lollipops, jelly beans, and of course me. Here's how my story starts. My parents had no children before I was born. One day my mother said to my father, I wish we had a child to liven up our house. I wouldn't care if it were only as big as my thumb. And sure enough, her wish came true. I was born as big as her thumb and never grew any bigger. See how I drive the family wagon? I'd sit in the horse's ear and tell him which way to go. I made up in brains what I lacked in size. Gee-up, gee-woe, is how I told the horse which way to go. Well, one day two circus men came by, saw me doing this, and wanted to buy me so I could do it in their circus. Father, of course, said no, but I wanted to see the world, and I talked him into it. I jumped on the brim of the ringmaster's hat, the better to see the world. I'll come back, don't worry, said I, and left. After a while, I realized the two circus men were bad, and so to get away, I ran down into a rabbit hole. Oh, it was fun. They were so angry, but they wouldn't get me out. And finally, they left, and I fell asleep. I was awakened by two robbers talking about robbing the house of a parson. You should have seen their faces when I popped out of my rabbit hole. Little did they know I was going to ruin their wicked plan. I told them I was small enough to go through a keyhole and get into the house and could help them steal the parson's silver, so they took me along. I got inside and made such a racket I woke up the house. Everyone came along and the robbers ran away. Now I was tired and went to sleep on some hay in the barn. I woke up with a start, for the maid had picked up my hay bed and was feeding me and the hay to the cow. Stop, I shouted as I landed in the cow's stomach. Oops, too late. Here I am in a cow's stomach. My, isn't it dark in here? And didn't I scare the milkmaid when I shouted from the cow's stomach? She thought the cow was talking. I heard her telling the parson about it.
Did you ever hear of a talking cow, of a talking cow, of a talking cow? Did you ever hear of a talking cow? Well, I just heard one right now. Yes, I just heard one right now.
The parson thought the devil had gotten into the cow because cows just don't speak. So he killed the cow, at which time a wolf came by and ate the cow with me still in its stomach.
I'm still hungry,
the wolf shouted. I know where there's food, said I, and led him to my house. Father, it's Tom, I shouted. I'm inside the wolf's stomach. My father promptly killed the wolf and out I popped. Father said,
Tom, where have you been?
I've been in a rabbit's hole. I've been inside a cow. I've been inside the stomach of a wolf, for sure. I've traveled east and west, so I know that home is best. And I won't go traveling anymore.